The James Webb Telescope discovers the first signs of life on TRAPPIST-1. The TRAPPIST-1 planetary system is one of the few star systems known to host 7 Earth-sized planets that may or may not support life. According to our new toy in space, how can James Webb's telescope locate life among these great candidates? The James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, will look for signs of life on 7 planets the size of Earth using a new observation method. Welcome to today's video. In December of last year, the James Webb Space Telescope was launched, taking over from the Hubble as the world's most powerful telescope. This brand new blitzy telescope is designed to shed light on our solar system and the planets orbiting other stars in the universe. As one of its key goals, it hopes to locate the TRAPPIST-1 planetary system, which contains 7 planets the size of Earth around an icy star. To be clear, we do not mean that you can go skiing on the surface of the star when we say it is ultra cool. A star with an effective temperature of less than 2700 Kelvin, about 4400 degrees Fahrenheit, is considered an ultra-cool dwarf star. By our standards, it's still sweatingly hot, but the exoplanets this dwarf star has to offer are somewhat different, because 3 of them are located within the star's habitable zone. This is just right temperature range for liquid water to exist on Earth's surface. The distance between Earth and TRAPPIST-1 in cosmic terms is only 39 light-years. 7 planets are intruding and have been studied extensively since their discovery. However, just 3 of these planets are in the habitable zone. Doesn't mean that they can support life. For a planet to be considered for our next real estate boom, it must first have a habitable zone. This is referred to as a biosignature. An exoplanet must have a similar composition to Earth's atmosphere in terms of gases such as methane, oxygen, water vapor, carbon dioxide, and a slew of others to be considered habitable. According to a new study, the James Webb Space Telescope could be the game changer we've been looking for in the quest for extraterrestrial life. A biosignature analysis of these Earth-sized planets' atmospheres with the Webb Telescope, astronomers hope, will be powerful enough to find signs of life on distant worlds like these. While watching this video, a telescope is working to accomplish this goal. But how can the Webb Telescope succeed in achieving what no other telescope has done before? The answer can be found in the skies. Even from where JWST, the James Webb Space Telescope, is circling at L2, the closest of these potentially habitable planets are still tens of light years distant. But this new telescope has some fresh tricks. When a planet stands in the way of our telescope and the host star of an exoplanet system, we can see it. We can determine how much of the star's light is obstructed en route to us by the planet's atmosphere using sensitive telescopes. Transit depth refers to the time it takes for light to go through a medium. Due to gaseous components' selective absorption of specific light wavelengths, it varies according to wavelengths. We can see which signals are missing when the star is transiting using a spectrometer telescope, a specialized instrument for analyzing light by wavelengths. This means that we can predict which gases will be present in the atmosphere. This technique is known as transit spectroscopy, and it's not a novel one for the Webb telescope. Hubble initially employed transit spectroscopy in 2002, and it has been widely used for almost a decade. In addition, transit spectroscopy presents a new problem. Objects in space between our telescope and the star may partially block our receiving light. Giant clouds of gases like hydrogen, which transport microscopic solid particles known as interstellar dust, are an excellent illustration of such impediments. Our telescopes cannot see much of the universe because of a thick layer of dust that obstructs most wavelengths of light. The exception to this rule is infrared light, whose long wavelengths allow it to pass through most dust without the filter. However, infrared light has its paradox. When temperatures rise above freezing, the infrared radiation is emitted by everything, including the telescope's gear, making analysis difficult. Such a temperature can be maintained in space with reasonable efficiency, making space telescopes a superior tool for investigating the cosmos. The near-infrared spectrometer and the mid-infrared instrument have been installed at the James Webb Space Telescope to detect and analyze radiation in the near and mid-infrared ranges. NASA has developed the largest astrophysical space observatory and the most difficult science mission ever for the first time. It is already being planned for future space telescopes to have these capabilities. Other telescopes haven't been able to detect minor rocky planets' atmospheres before the James Webb Space Telescope, making this discovery particularly interesting. As of now, there is a lot of debate in the field about whether or not these planets have atmospheres, especially in the innermost ones. As for the molecules that make up each planet's atmosphere, we expect a result within a year. But that may not be the case if the planet's atmospheres has clouds. So we'll have to wait and see. It may take up to 30 transits to affirm the existence of a planet with a hazy atmosphere, such as Venus. Although it will take longer, the Webb telescope can still accomplish this. When the system was younger, the world may have lost water and the star was hotter. Webb may detect evidence of this. When this occurs, the oxygen in the atmosphere may be abiotic, meaning living organisms did not produce it. However, this could be a deceptive signal of biological activity. Abiotic versus biotic sources of oxygen must be established, which will require further research. Many rocky planets like ours are being discovered in our Milky Way galaxy. The James Webb Space Telescope will be an excellent tool for astronomers to investigate these planets. There are billions of such worlds on Earth, and the Webb may give the first compelling proof of life on one or more of them. Webb's telescope can begin its search for extraterrestrial life in any other star system that the TRAPPIST. What are your expectations for this new star system? Please share your thoughts in the comment section below.